November 6, 2020. This is No Cover TV. Holla! Welcome to the show. This is cast from left to right. I'm gonna just go with the next mic, Isaac.
What up?
And mic number three, Sean.
Hey everybody, how's it going?
Talking down mic, please. And hi, welcome motherfucking back.
Heyo.
My guy.
What's up?
I'm here.
Bud.
I've made it.
So excited to see you back. So excited.
Thank you.
Stefan?
Hey, what's up, everybody? Good to see you.
Oh, there back. It is. There yeah. It is.
Oh.
One more time?
Say it again?
Yeah.
Good to see you, everybody. Good. Yeah, fantastic.
And then this dick.
Dick? Who's the dick?
Captain Dick.
Who's a dick? He's a dick.
Other people that we have in studio today, we have Pand over there.
Pants, yay.
We got...
pants.
Names.
Pans. We have Adrian.
Wait. Yeah.
And then we have Brittany in the corner.
Brittany in the corner. Nobody puts Brittany in the corner.
Dude, that's messed up.
And the big brains behind it...
Brains.
...is our man, Barang.
Chris,
Chris, big brain, brain.
Do you want
to... Moving the camera like a boomerang to get to him.
No camera for you?
Yeah.
Well, definite, a rough week, right?
Was it?
Oh, my God.
A slow week.
It definitely was. All right, so I just want to, before we go on to that, this week we have Plastic Culture on.
Woo!
Hell yeah.
And I think they smoke a lot of weed.
Perfect.
I don't know. Fuck, I'm hoping that's what the vibes I got. We also have freaking wide world renowned psychic medium, Patty Nigri. And we are going to do a seance with her. That's why we have this table set up over here. It's pretty dope.
Looks neat.
I am super excited for this one.
Hell fucking
and
yeah.
And we're trying to figure out, is it Sean or is it me that's the evil one? If you rewind the show back a few weeks, we had we were doing the Charlie Challenge, and I ended up saying, hey, am I evil? And then Sean said within the same...
I said it first, actually. I said, am I evil? And then, am I evil?
And then I said it right after, and then it moved.
After, just fucking, yes. Oh, shit, who's evil?
That was a trip.
So we're trying to see if there's anyone attached.
And we've played this video like 200 times or something like that. There's no way anybody was fucking with it. That was straight Charlie communicating with us. So it's either you or me, dude. One of us is evil.
Something's attached. Adrian also feels that she has something attached to her. So, and she's worked as a mortician for a minute. She's had some tragedy in her life, and she's also curious. I am excited to be back. I'm so happy to have this crew. I mean, if I can add one more person to this cast, I would definitely want to add Jesse. God knows I've asked him.
Quit being a little bitch.
Really?
I think he would definitely be a great... Oh, my God.
That'd be like the vortex of the tripex of trifectaness.
But he's pussy-whipped in his...
Hey, yeah, I didn't say that.
I'm not saying that either.
I didn't say that.
And then if we can get Tard back, we'll get rid of Adrian and get Tard back.
Don't be mean. He's not coming back.
Well, you just want somebody to pick on.
And...
Pants.
I'll get rid of Pants.
Okay.
So I'll get rid of those two for a Tard. I'll trade you guys. You guys go to...
That's a pretty high value. That's a pretty good deal.
That's a good draft pick.
Yeah.
It's pretty good. I'll give you two girls for a Tard.
Yeah.
Ooh. Is she a free agent right now?
Who, Tard?
Yeah.
No, Tard lives in Alabama.
Oh.
Two girls, one Tard?
I thought he went to...
I've seen that.
Visalia sold, yeah.
Oh, he went to a blue state?
Shit. No. He ended up going to Visalia. He sold vacuum cleaners up there.
I thought you were going to say Valium. What? I almost thought he was going to say Valium.
Vacuum cleaners, straight up.
Really dirty there.
Kirby. Yeah. Fucking pyramid scheme.
Fucking,
man. They almost bamboozled me.
They bamboozled my man, Tard.
Fuck.
And it wasn't a clever name that we named him Tard. Mm. He got bamboozled to go sell...
Kirby's
in Visalia. Of all, that's like the worst of the worst of the worst. Mm-mm. Like, what happened when you went to California? Oh, I got trapped in a pyramid scheme and sold freaking Kirby's in Visalia.
I almost found B. I did it one weekend in Bakersfield. So
one weekend.
That's because I was like, they're gonna bamboozle me.
Bakersfield.
Yeah, Bakersfield.
Who the fuck wants to buy a $500? Kirby.
It wasn't a five. It was like $1,000.
Yeah, well, and this is what they do though. They're like $1,200 for you though.
$500. $999.
Can you do $1,100?
Like, what? No. I don't want to do this.
Hold on. Let me throw dirt on your carpet.
Oh, and they do that too. So that's like one of their like tricks of the trade.
Yeah.
They'll throw dirt on your carpet. They'll clean it up, and it looks so good compared to your dirty fucking carpet.
Yeah.
But how do you get the blood out of the carpet after you've just murdered them?
Well, that's another. Kirby that's for another story.
I feel bad. I suckered like an 84-year-old person to buy it, and then the next day the wife came and goes, "Hey, we can't afford it." And then so then the girl had to come and do the demo again because he thought I didn't do the demo right. And I go, "Bitch, I did the same thing you did." But I mean,
then they leave it there too.
Yeah.
They leave all like the paddings, because they have these little filters.
Yeah.
Like, you want your children walking or crawling in this?
Filth. It's in like, this grime and filth. Pretty much insulting the people that don't have any house cleaning, no ways to clean their house.
So anyways, real fast, I want to give a shout out to my boy, TIE Fighter.
Oh, shit. Is he D2, TIE?
Damn.
He sent me a package. TIE Fighter, let me see, where are we at? Give him some love, Chris, right there. Hell yeah.
Chris is the most lackadaisical producer guy. He's like... Can we close up, zoom in on that?
Looks like it was worn.
He probably did. It even increases the value. Wrinkles were included.
Relaxed.
Ty's going to be on our show coming up. I'm excited to see him. He's a talent. So go check him out. I think Ty _ Fighter.
Yeah.
He's awesome. All right, let me see. We're going to play, we have Plastic Culture, Patty Nigri, and we're also going to play, we have the World Greatest Segment, and we're also going to play the game Truths and a Lie. So, right before, we're about to go to commercial break right now. Well, before that, I don't know if you guys noticed, like for the past month, I haven't been shaving.
Oh, here we go.
And it's because of No Shave November, right? And you're wondering, like, Tim, how do you get such a rugged beard after you haven't shaved for a month?
I was just going to ask you that.
Dude, right here, Viking Revolution Beard Oil.
Oh.
Listen, I'm going to show you how this shit's done.
You started No Shave November in... like the second week of October?
Sean, please.
Yeah, because every time I start in November, it doesn't look like I had a beard at the end of it.
Not in the middle of the infomercial. Please, Sean.
My mistake.
Yeah. Okay.
So this is what you do. You put it in your hand.
Uh-huh. Sorry, too much.
And then you go like this. And then you know how like I have a lot of hair on my like cheeks area.
Yeah,
you put that shit on there.
In the past
yeah, you missed that dude, that's one.
Wait, this is one, dude. Wait.
Why are you trying to grow beard hair on your upper cheek?
Yeah. Dude? Wait, is this Taki's perfume or is this beard oil?
No, because this is beard oil. See, the people that don't have rugged beards like me and Dennis, you guys don't know about
the bow with the patches.
You can't.
It's actually not patches. It's actually No Shave November, and I'm doing it for.
But you legit have a cancer patch. For men.
Yeah.
You have like two extra because you've been applying too much oil in this one spot.
So
you
got, that's no, seriously, the problem.
If you look at your face, no, look at your face.
I cut it on purpose.
No, use your eyes and look at your face. You have two extra
Isaac,
patches
you got a vacuum cleaner you
on your cheek right here.
I accidentally shaved him.
Hold on,
wait, you shaved everything around. Just
I just wanted the patches.
Yeah. Are you putting that on your gooch too, or what's going on?
No, I'm just in my gooch. Or what's the purpose of beard oil, guys?
I don't know.
To oil your already existing beard.
Yeah. Why are you putting it on the skin? Why are you oiling your skin?
I've been 3 weeks without shaving, guys.
You should have. You should have started No Shave November in July.
You need face cream.
You guys are fucking haters.
No.
So here's what we're gonna do. We are going to do two truths and a lie. I'm gonna break it down right now. Okay. I lost my virginity at 17.
This is not
17?
True. This is not true. Oh.
I once went on a cocaine bender for 3 days.
This is absolutely 100% true.
And my wife doesn't like Dennis.
This is... That might be true. Wait, what was the first one? No. The first one...
Wait. Why does she...
No, that's a lie. The first one is a lie.
That I lost my virginity at 17?
Yes.
All right. What about you? What do you think is the lie?
Who doesn't like think Dennis? The lie is that your wife doesn't like me. I think she like loves me, dude. What the hell?
What do you think the lie is?
You lost your virginity.
What do you think the lie is?
It's got to be the virginity, because who the hell loses?
He lost his virginity earlier than that.
Why were you there?
He was like 13, bro.
Yeah.
I think your wife does like
me. Yeah,
but she doesn't like.
Well, what's the lie?
What's the lie?
Oh, that she doesn't like Dennis? Sean, what do you think the lie is?
I have no idea. What were the three options?
I lost my virginity at 17.
Okay.
My wife doesn't like Dennis.
And then that beard oil works for his face.
And what was the other one?
That's a lie.
Oh, your wife doesn't like Dennis likes Dennis.
No, I know. But what was the other one?
The virginity?
Virginity?
Yeah.
Dennis?
Oh, shit. I don't even know the second one.
Oh, shit. We haven't even smoked weed yet.
It's the first one. You lost your virginity at like 12.
What about you? Chris.
What was the second one?
Chris, what about you? What do you think?
All right, cool. Thanks, bro.
The first one? Okay.
He doesn't know what the first one is, to be honest.
The lie?
Obviously, the second one's not the truth because no one remembers it. He doesn't.
Well, the second one is the truth.
Yeah.
Whatever it was the truth.
You could have written them down, Tim.
I know. I just forgot. I did have it. It's in my book. I didn't want to open it. The lie is
the virginity.
The virginity.
Yeah.
So she doesn't like you, dude. I'll tell you the story. Okay.
What the fuck?
So we
welcome to the club.
Hold on,
bro.
I'm about to tell you the
maybe
story.
I know.
Welcome
maybe
to
the I club. Know.
All right. So we have there's things that are happening in our No Cover organization that are beyond our wildest dreams that could have happened. We really can't get into detail here in a public setting. There's NDAs involved, but there are some filmings about to happen in Burbank for a television show.
California.
For with us. So me and Dennis were talking about it. I was like, all right, Dennis, you down to go? You're down to go. So last night I tell Alana, I was like, yeah, the 14th through the 16th, I'm not going to be here. I'm going to be in Burbank. And she goes, well, who are you going to go with? I said, oh, I'm just going to go with Dennis. And then she was like, why Dennis? He just barely got back. Why did he get to go? And I was like, he's just going to go. I've talked about it with him. He's going to go. And then she was like, well, I don't understand why I can't go. I've been here for the whole time, and you're not on the show. So you can't go.
I suck your dick every night.
So then as I'm going to the bathroom, I'm walking away from the conversation. She yells, this is why I hate Dennis. This is
I gotta talk to her.
This is No Cover Television. And we'll be right back with Patty Negri after this.
Woo! Hey man, you better go make
Yo, yo, microphone check, make it a microphone check. Give it a microphone, I make the make it a microphone dead. Don't step to me, newbie, I could truly be moody. I could have played the fucking Grinch in the movies. I've been a part-time shadow cat, part-time. That is not a guy that I would ever want to try to battle rap. Snap, crackle, pop, mind fried to a crisp. Make an MC into a wide-eyed lunatic.
I'm in the trenches. bitches with a dope fiend. I'm circulating from the coke until they go thin. The kid that started with 100 grams, now he can turn a full slab into 100 grand. They claim to be who they ain't. Try to knock my hustle, they can't. I'm pull this burner out of my pain. They claim to be who they ain't.
Try to battle rap. Snap, crackle, pop, mind fried to a crisp. Make an MC into a wide-eyed lunatic.
Thank you.
out where he stand.
They said hello right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
And they're throwing money at Phil.
Yeah, Phil. Whoop.
Take it
yeah.
off.
There's some stuff. It sounded like a penny.
Phil.
Yeah, they're getting impatient, dude.
Yeah, they're not.
All right. Wait. We're back. Hey, what up? We're back. No Cover Television. I'm your host, Tim Amoroso. And in studio, we have the world-renowned Patty Negri. Hello, ma'am. How are we?
I am excellent. Patty. Thank you so much for having me.
We're so excited to have you.
Thanks.
Explain for the people who might not know.
Yes.
What is it that you are known for?
What we are going for is we are going to lift the veil between the world and talk to the dead.
So you're a medium?
I am a medium. I have been literally seeing the other side since I was 3 or 4 years old. I've always had an obsession with the dead, but not even in a morbid way. I literally did my first seance when I was 7 or 8 years old. I think kids actually do see them. So some of this stuff is kind of new. I work very elementally in the way I work, kind of like a Native American earth pagans like I am, with nature's elements to lift and to protect. So we'll see what's here. We'll call in whoever you so desire, and we'll shut it down afterwards unless you don't want me to, but I will anyway.
So you started things when you're three? I started seeing
spirits when I was 3 or 4, completely.
How does that work? Like, what did you see at first?
It just said alcohol. It's your spirits are funny. You've got spirits.
Is it pre-recordings or is it just an amplifier and it's saying?
It's hearing the words.
Yeah. That thing doesn't just say alcohol whenever randomly. Like there's
everything it's been saying has been on so far.
Yeah.
Because I saw alcohol,
that was really out of the corner of my eye. I saw Sean taking.
Someone's knocking. They said Sarah.
Okay, so when you're three, what do you see?
When you're three, I just knew that the guy in the closet wasn't my imaginary friend. The little critters that were under the bed were real. They gave me real information. I could tell my mom real stuff that they said. I just knew stuff.
And you're Native American?
No. I just work at an elemental, similar to the Native American path, though mine's a pagan path, yeah. No, I thought everybody could. And I honestly do think that kids actually are much more psychic or much more intuitive. But in our very non-mystical, modern Western society, it just gets taught out of us. Oh, your imagination. Even our religion isn't very mystical anymore.
What did your mother think when you told her that?
She said grandma did that too. She said yeah.
Oh, no.
It runs in the family. So, yeah, it just didn't get taught out of me. So then I spent my whole life literally, I was when I was seven, and I went in my little suburban Long Beach hallway where there was no windows, and I wanted to call in the dead people, and then I realized I didn't know any dead people. I was seven or eight, and so it was John Kennedy and Marilyn Monroe in late 60s, all these people that I could think of, and my windowless, lightless hall filled with orbs and lights running through and around, and me and Sherry Jones weren't running out screaming, but inside I was jumping up and down. I'm like, yes, this is real, and this is controllable. You could call it in, and you can shut it down, and you could call it in, and you can shut it down.
What is this realm that we're in right now?
Our three-dimensional realm is our three-dimensional realm. Gravity counts, you know, stuff. I mean, nothing's solid. We know that. That's seventh grade science. We're not solid. We're moving atoms. The other realms out there, however many there are, there's like a veil between them. So, you know, some people naturally see through it. Some people don't. You have to kind of shut down your left reasoning brain and let your right intuitive brain take over if you want to start developing that. But this is our world, and actually we're in charge of this world. Most people don't know that, so they give their power away. When you see the crazy stuff on camera, people allowing all this possession and stuff like that, they've sort of, unless you have a severe addiction problem or a severe mental imbalance, you can control it. People just don't know that, so they give it over.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy. But it's a pretty cool world. I mean, most ghosts are cray. I mean, like Stefan, we go on to, you know, you go to the prisons and the insane asylums and all that. And yeah, there's a bunch of dark and scary ghosts. But most ghosts are really fun. They hang out. I bet you guys are having fun.
What are they doing here? How are they able to communicate, or and why would they?
Because time and space, I do not believe there is time and space on the other side. So they could be here and they can be there. I think why they do, when they see somebody like me or you guys all wanting to do this, they're fine, but it gives them almost like being alive. It gives them real time back and forth conversation. You know, whether it's a little seance around my dining room table or there's 500 people in an auditorium, the ghosts love it because they get to really communicate. They get to touch you on the shoulder. They get to whisper in your ear. They get to do stuff, and you're communicating back and forth. And think about it. If you didn't have time in your life, you were just happy and floating, and you looked in on the kids, and you looked in on whatever, somebody consciously talking to you is kind of fun. And they love creative people. They love music. They love musicians. That's why theaters are always haunted, and you know, music places are always haunted. And plus, you get really good ghosts that come hang out and stuff, because in all my experience, big in life, big in death. Little, you know, Bob the little banker who lives his whole life in a cubicle is going to be Bob the little ghost. Somebody who's like, yeah, I play the Roxy, is going to be that ghost coming here.
Are you born with that gift, or can anybody have it? Because I've tried. As much as I've gone with the Stefan, I just never saw anything. I never heard anything. It's just, even though I've tried, am I trying too hard?
Because trying, then you're going into that logical brain again, which you kind of have to shush. Just allow. Don't try. Just allow. And there's lots of exercises. I could sit down with you for 10 minutes and have you practice breathing stuff, you know, learning to make a candle dance, moving things around, stuff like that, learning to move energy and then open energy. So, yeah, I think, I mean, anybody can learn it. Not everybody's going to be the same good. Like, anybody could take piano lessons. I took for years. I'm not that good. But everybody can learn a little bit. I could read notes and play, you know. So some people are born, you know, playing Mozart. So, but I do think that people can. A good way I have people do it is while they're asleep, put a glass of water by their bed because it's a conduit for spirit, and just say, let me talk to ghosts, or let me talk to spirit guides, or let me talk to dead grandma, or what is the meaning of life?
Before you go to sleep,
you set the water before you go to sleep, and then you go to sleep, and you'll either get it in dream time or downloads. Yeah.
Is there anything is there a question that you would want answered about life in general?
Oh.
Or does it just... Or could you search that answer through your spirituality?
The more I learn, the more I know I don't know, as with all of us. Mm-hmm. And I love learning. Besides that, I'm teaching all the time. I'm in school all the time. What do I want to know? I don't know. Every day it would be a different thing. Every day I learn crazy stuff like, okay, finally figure out who you – I believe in past life. Okay, figure out who you were in a past life. I knew it was. I found the house by myself. I knew every inch of the house by myself. We wrote alike. We were born at these 30-year increments. Okay, I believe it. I am this person. And then that person came to a seance. It's like, what the – how does that work?
Do you ever question the meaning of life?
I think it's school. I think life is school. I think it's fun and it's school. I love people. I think it's, you know, we could skate through school or we could be a grad school or we could be a junior college. We could be whatever. We're choices. But I think it's what we make with it.
When you go through life and I know you don't know all the answers.
Yeah.
It's a TV show. I'm sorry.
TV show?
Yeah. It's a TV show.
It's figuring out where we are, I guess.
It's straight. I'm sorry I had to stop you, but that thing straight up said TV show.
And we haven't even lifted the veil yet.
I want to also tell you guys that we have, I don't know how true this is, but on our YouTube it says 19.1 million subscribers.
It's the ghost.
I swear. It's a 19 point. Chris, is it not?
It still says it.
Okay. That's the spirits do that. They love this. When I first opened, as far as like followers and stuff, I have a haunted doll. I didn't bring her. Her name's Belle. I had never done a Facebook Live before. Never. And even when I do them now, it's like, ooh, 300. Ooh, maybe 1,000. Open that doll. I have 50,000 people on my very first Facebook Live ever. It wasn't me. It was a spirit.
So do you think that's what's happening? Just on a side note, I know that we...
Maybe.
Unless Chris is awesome at Photoshop.
Live Photoshop.
Yeah.
Did everyone see 19? Did you screenshot that, Chris? Okay. So just in case. All right. So my question I was getting to, and not that you might know, you might not know, but it would be very naive of me not to ask this question. Mm. I know you're certain that there is something after this life.
Mm-hmm.
What... through your learning and your studying, have you come to a determination what you believe is on the other side?
I believe, again, I study religion. I believe it is closest to what the ancient Sumerians think, which was, if you live in Pittsburgh, you go to Pittsburgh heaven. If you're Christian, you go to the pearly gates. If you're this, you go to that. Almost more like the Matrix than anything else. Almost more like the Matrix. You are creating what you kind of, we create it. Again, it's a lot for our little brains. But so if this is what you're thinking you're going to get, you're going to get. I think we become energy and there's lots of options. And spirits seem, again, 90%, most spirits are really happy. Dead, when people die and I go have to talk to them and all that, dead people are like, woohoo, I'm not sick anymore. Woohoo, I'm not old anymore. It's the living. It's hard left on those left living.
Crap.
So what's the deal with the ones that are evil and cause harm and stuff?
Okay, well...
What's their...
Okay, these are, in my experience, these are the realms. So there's ghosts, which we're talking to. Ghosts or humans were things that were living humans. Most people are good, but there are some very bad ones. There are some serial killers and all that kind of stuff. Of course, there are good ones and bad ones. There's residual. We're not going to do residual haunting. That's the ones that are more like videotape Memorex that don't interact with you. You guys get those at places. The other realm that we could visit on the other side is the everything else realm, and that's the things that were never human. Ghosts are, we're humans. The everything else realm, it could be elementals, angels, demons, and everything, all that in between, fairies, you know, all of the...
What's your take on jinns?
On what?
Jinns.
On the jinns? I think it's just things developed by the culture that they're in. I think that they are a spirit of themselves, and we create it. Like in England, they're going to create this, and the jinns are going to do this. I think that they're a spirit, a non-human spirit. Well, I don't know. I guess it's who you talk to. It's like everything gets reps and stuff, but I think I'm a djinn and I have to be bad. Not necessarily. You know, almost anything, even in this world, not the other world, that we think is bad luck or bad is usually just powerful. like breaking a mirror or walking under a ladder or the number 13 or a black cat. None of that is bad. It's just powerful. It could be really bad or really good. But we as simple humans kind of go, it's has got to be bad because it's powerful. And I think the same sort of would be with djinns.
Holy cow.
Yeah.
Well, I am super... I'm super excited to have you here, and I love this. I love learning, and I love figuring out, you know what I mean? And any way that we can get close to certain answers, I'm there.
Okay. All right. So you want to do this?
Heck yeah.
Okay. All right, so hardest part, everybody uncross your legs. Everybody uncross your arms. We're all here together. Again, I'm going to work very simply in elemental way, calling it up. These machines are new. They're kind of a cross between, like, Ovilus ghost boxes and all the kind of stuff like Stefan has. This is one of Stefan's, and we can get ghosts to talk through it. These are brand new inventions. These are prototypes. Taken off like an Ovilus thing. So we'll see what they do. So far, they've been pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Chatting it up.
Chatty. They're very chatty.
Oh, they're very chatty. Oh, I was like, Patty, what? No. And they said Patty the other day. Traditionally, I've always been very old school, working with dowsing rods. If anybody's seen these, been around forever, witching rod. You find water in the desert with them. Contractors use them to find water lines. But for divination, they cross on yes and they don't cross on no. Like, we are in Pittsburgh right now. No. Where are we? Oxnard? Santera? We are in Oxnard right now. Yes, we are. We are in Pittsburgh right now. No. Now, you guys.
Like, it's normal. Like, okay, that was magic.
It's completely normal. Okay. Tim.
Look, no. I just did magic.
What?
And I'll hand these to anybody. Tim, you are wearing a red shirt. Tim, you have Easter bunny ears on. No. It just works.
I'm trying to look at her fingers and stuff.
I can't. I'm not that good. we are at the Eiffel Tower.
The spirit said wow.
Yeah. It said wow. Right now, good. I will tell you, we have not raised the veil yet, but Stefan, do you feel it? There's a spirit in that corner.
There was absolutely.
Okay, so.
Standing in front of you a minute ago.
Okay, so spirit, can you point to where you are right now?
Oh my gosh.
What? It's creepy because, like, when you felt started it, I'm cold on this side.
Yep, yeah. That's a sign.
Hold on, are we looking at this, guys?
Dude, why'd I come back?
On all shows to come back to.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So anyway, so that's what it is. I'm going to be burning some herbs, some oils.
I just got cold.
All sorts of stuff. It is cold. We got
it. It's getting really cold here.
Really cold.
Wow, we haven't opened the veil yet, dude.
All right. So, okay. Uncross, everybody. Just take a deep breath in. And exhale. Just balance. Another deep breath in. And exhale. One more. Keep slowly breathing as we're going. I do want to call the east winds to blow through this place, to blow out anything negative and dark, and to blow in true communication with spirits on the other side. I want to call in the south, the fire, the passion, the creativity, again, to burn away blocks and burn away miscommunication and mold it into true communication with the living and with the other side. I want to call in the sweet waters of the West, the emotions, mists of the ancestors. May they rise and communicate with us. And lastly, I want to call in the North, Mother Earth herself. Keep us safe, keep us grounded, yet let us reach for the stars. There is a place where we all go, where ne'er the frost or cold winds blow, and friends remembered reunite, and those who hate forget their spite. We gather round these gentle beings. We call you now to bless our meeting. And for the living, these spirits do thrive. And now, for the living, may the dead come alive. With the ringing of this bell, we lift the veil twixt heaven and hell. We call the spirits now and why. We call them in to by our side. We are between the worlds.
Okay. You've got a little entourage here. This guy hangs out a lot, whoever this is. He's when I say attached to one of you, it doesn't mean he's attached, like he has an attachment. But he knows one of you.
Tell me about it.
I am.
Oh, my God.
Shut up.
No.
Okay, I will tell you about it. He is thin-ish, tall-ish, not skinny or anything, but thin-ish and tall-ish. He looks like a musician, kind of mid-length hair. He shows himself. He shows himself probably in his 30s. Sometimes they show themselves younger, but I would say he passed young. Does anybody want to claim this guy?
He said they said January.
January? Oh, thank you. I'm not used to listening to you. So January, did you pass in January? Wait, let's ask the Rot, shall we? Okay. Hi, guy. So were you a musician?
November.
Okay. Do you know somebody here? Do any of you know somebody who died like in their 30s who was a musician?
I know a lot of people that died in their 30s as musicians. So.
Related to the
show.
Okay.
So
I'm trying to think. I mean, the only people that I remember that were close to the show is Ross. No. Yeah, remember bald guy. Ross, I'm brain farting. No one in 30s, 20s.
That's what about that guy that died in the car with a boulder?
Yeah, I know. That's what I was thinking, him. What? But he's bald. They're both bald.
Okay, so you're not one. You're not bald, are you? No. You got hair.
The only thing I can think of is my brother died at 30, and he was born in November. But
okay, did so he?
Was I don't he, know if I. I don't think he was a musician though.
But did he love music? Did he love you?
Oh yeah,
did
he want to
hang
music,
out with
yeah.
you. What was his name?
Paul.
Paul, okay. Paul, is that you? He's really attached to one of you. Oh, Paul. Paul, okay. Where's your brother?
Oh.
Dude, wow. Chill.
Okay, no. So we just can't. Paul, where are you?
Okay. That's crazy. I have chills right now.
Yeah.
It's
freezing. So I feel for things like chills, obviously.
I feel it. Do you feel it now?
A soft touch.
I feel it on my legs right now.
Yeah.
It just keeps going higher.
Yeah, the leg thing.
Oh, freaky.
Did it say Ventura? I don't know what it said. There's also.
It would be interesting. It does make sense. He would be following me around.
He following you around. Yeah. So.
You got a question for him?
Yeah. Do you have anything you want to ask him or tell him?
I missed the shit out of him. I love. I mean, I was young when he passed away, and. He would always give me candy.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Dude. Yeah.
What happened?
It just said I like candy.
Oh, man.
Isaac, for real?
Yeah. He would always give me candy. And he knows, yeah, well, okay. Well,
blue?
Okay.
Well, you got a blue mic?
Well, no, blue is my favorite color. I do. I do forgive you, man.
Aww.
I love you.
Did he say forgive you?
Yeah.
He said, do you forgive?
Yeah. Yeah, he said, do you forgive?
I feel like one of his I was very young when he died, and he was like, I was like a son to him, and I feel like one of his biggest like things was like, I'm not gonna get to see him grow. It was just, and he loved the shit out of me. I know that. I feel that.
Yeah.
And no. I think maybe that was like, you know, I'm sorry that I wasn't there for you, but I always feel him every day. Like, I feel like, and it makes sense, like, that he's always with me.
Yeah,
and
he's always with you.
Yeah,
and he'll even show you more if you want. Yeah, just be open to him, or ask him for signs, or ask him for specific signs.
What did he say?
Something about the Lakers.
No, he wasn't really big into sports. He wasn't a sports guy.
LeBron sucks.
Yeah. But it makes sense.
But he's trying to say something.
Yeah, he's trying to say something.
Sounded like he said Matt, then Dave.
Seven.
There's, I don't know. What
does seven mean anything to you?
Not really, no.
Okay.
It's not me.
Okay. Yeah,
Lakers and seven.
Ever Nick?
Did it just call my name?
It said seven.
It said like Tim or Tim.
Dude, it did say Tim.
Did you say Tim?
Did you say Tim again?
Did you say Tim? Were you trying to say Tim? Yeah.
Answer the phone. Oh, dude.
Wait, check your phone, Tim. Is there a message?
Spirits are really using to learning to use phones.
Yeah.
They must say. They really are learning.
Wait, do you have...
Are they okay?
No, they're good. I just checked on them.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, it's getting warmer in here. It's getting lighter in here. He's kind of liking this.
No, he's a showman for sure. He has a thing for the theatrical.
Talk clearer, please, into these new machines. He's doing something that I'm not sure if he's going like this with his head or he's making like a tent.
Oh, he's doing this.
Okay.
He's doing this. He would tell everyone that we were kids or we were father and son, and he would cover his face to notice that we looked almost identical from the face
up. Oh, that's what he's doing.
From the face up. We looked exactly the same from the face up. And he would always be like, that's my kid, look. And then he would cover my face, and then it would be...
I don't know if he's a paid actor or not.
No,
this is weird.
This is not.
This is crazy.
And it's funny because we've been talking kind of more about him on a personal level. Me and him have been talking about my brother.
He's been here.
Because my son's birthday is the same day as his birthday.
And I told, the same birthday. We have the same birthday.
Okay. So anything else you want to ask him or tell him? Or is there something you want to
This is your time,
us,
dude.
Paul?
If ever you had a chance to talk, to have a mulligan or do-over, this is it, Ice.
Maybe there's that joke you always wanted to tell him.
I just hope that I can make him proud. You know, I hope that, you know, he helps me through the way. And most of the stuff I do is for, is because he inspired me to do it out of his outgoingness, out of his, like, his personality. I miss him. I love him. I know I haven't spent a lot of time with him. You know, he was a lot older than me. It was like a big generational gap. But I just hope that he just, you know, watches over me and just guides me.
He does.
That's so fucking crazy, this.
Mm-hmm. He totally does. He, you have some up in a corner. Do you notice something up in a corner? Where, not here, but where you live or something? And I don't know if it's an energy thing. He keeps kind of pointing up to a corner. Maybe you notice something there, right? When you go home, you will.
There is a corner that I keep staring at
Yeah.
When at work, yeah.
Yeah.
Followed you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's where he hangs, in the corner. It's an active little corner. That's why you stare at it.
Oh, man. Okay, well, I need to change the things I do in my room then.
He's in that corner too.
He's getting...
Ask him the question. Have you seen me do it?
No.
ask him if it's big.
What do you say?
How's the cat?
How's the cat? The cat, well, our family had a bunch of animals, so it just depends on which one he's talking about.
His cat? Or cat he was?
I see, here's again. There's a lot of stuff that it was a gap between the age group. So I was really, really young. So I think I was 7. And he was 29 when he passed.
Wow.
So I know he accelerated all the stuff when I grew up. He would take me to all these things and show me all this stuff, and it's just crazy.
That's cool.
I'm, that's amazing. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh my gosh. I'm just so shocked. I don't even know what to ask or say.
That's okay. He said you have to eat better.
Oh, shit.
That's my boy.
That's true. This is very true.
He said he's fat. Huh? Yeah. Is that what he said?
No, he didn't say he's fat because he was talking about it, like digestion or something like that. I don't know. He didn't say you were fat. He just said you have
to eat.
Did
that thing just say marshmallow?
Yeah, marshmallow.
He's
not wrong on that.
Yeah. Is he a ball buster?
Oh yeah, he's just like me. But like, I think he was just like me. Yeah. I will do that, brother. I will do that.
He's scared for you, dude.
He's scared that you're not gonna do it.
No, I will.
What did? What was that? Last
car.
Word?
I think he said car.
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 Car? Does that mean anything to you?
Not been particularly, no.
What about any other spirits in the room?
Yeah, we'll go on to other spirits now. But do you remember some bird thing you used to do when you were a kid?
A bird thing?
Yeah. He's doing this funny thing. And I just figured maybe...
Is that Thriller?
Maybe.
Did you guys do Thriller together?
I don't know. I don't know. I mean, this again. I don't. I'm really good at with. I don't remember. I don't know.
I you know. It's just how I might. Yeah, I could be deciphering it wrong.
I did just buy the Michael Jackson Thriller jacket tonight, which is weird. I found it at a thrift store for like $5.
Mm-hmm. Really? Well,
so it's out in my car.
There you go. Well, then maybe Michael Jackson's here. He's gonna do.
Son away.
I've talked to him twice. It's weird. It's weird. He's very shy.
Well, I will eat. I will eat better.
Okay. Okay. Tonight. My arm.
Oh, I've been touching my arm for like the past 2 minutes.
Okay, right here, fine. So there you go. So maybe he's touching your arm. He's like, All right. So anyway, that's how it works. Anybody want to ask for somebody? Want to see who's here? Anybody want to ask? Or you have questions you had? For the spirits, while we are here.
You want to introduce? I don't have a mic.
I
forgive. Again, it's his last words.
Is there any? I'm curious if there's anybody else here.
Adrian, you said you were feeling something at one point.
I feel something all the time.
Yeah.
Okay, let's try to focus on that one.
Karen? Did it say Karen?
Yeah. Sounded like Karen. Okay, there is, it's an entourage, there's all these things, I think, there's an older woman and an older guy. I don't think they know each other. It could be like a mother-grandmother kind of thing. She has.
Together.
They're you are together. Okay, you're together. She has brown wavy hair, short round face.
Uh oh.
That's your mom.
No, that's the lady I bought the car from.
Oh, and it just said car.
I bought this car that I have from the lady from where I worked. Shortly after that, she died.
I've never heard her do that before.
But I was in her room doing some work, and the caregiver told me that she was sleeping, but I think she was already dead, because shortly, just maybe an hour later, they came to pick her up and take her away.
Yeah, I've got goosebumps all over from that, and I don't know what that was just doing that thing.
What was that?
Is that a good thing?
We don't know. It's never happened
before. We don't know. It's a new invention. So, yeah.
So I'm wondering if I really liked her a lot.
So is this a lady with the car with the brown wavy hair? Yes.
Ooh.
Okay. So who do you know? Why are you here?
Did the check bounce?
Yeah.
She's pointing at you.
Lost. She's lost?
You're lost? Ooh, do we need to cross you over? Are you lost? No. So you're just hanging around because you can. Yeah.
Well, all right then. She likes
Phil. She thinks
you're kind of cute.
Phil. Man, Phil, you got the magic touch.
I think she thinks you're kind of cute.
Playa.
Oh, she's like her. She's got that ghostly strike.
Friend, as a friend.
Did
Yeah, see, you are intuitive. You said you felt something, right?
No, I said I tried to feel things, but I couldn't.
But even this, you kind of went to her and you said you had a feeling and it went with something.
Well, because of what they were saying. It was
car.
Yeah.
Car. Do you still have the car?
Yeah. It's out front.
Okay. So do you hang out in the car?
No. Oh. We have a haunted car. You can carpool.
Okay.
Ask her what her name is.
Okay. What do you, I forget, what's your name? This won't do it. Do you have, will you tell us your name?
I think it's saying you'll tell her the name, Phil. I think it's saying you know the answer.
Say the name and then watch if it crosses.
She can confirm her.
Her nickname was Tracy, but her real name was Betty.
Tracy, Betty. I wonder what this has been spilling out, too. It's another. Okay. Are you Sally? Are you Bertha? Are you Tracy? Are you Beth? Are you Betty? Say something on the
light
machine.
The candle.
Light the candle. We have the candles lit.
She's spunky.
She's spunky. She likes you. Do you
turn colors?
Do you hang out in the car, right? With Phil. Yeah. Can he see you in his mirror if he looks with the side of his eye? Do you protect him in the car?
Wow.
She's good.
Lee's house.
Wise ass?
Yep.
That sounds about right. That's Phil.
I was never like that towards her.
Okay. Yeah, right.
You're being a wise ass right now.
She knows. She probably hears you.
You okay? There's nothing weird.
After this,
like, I want to know who appeared to me in 1992 during the earthquake.
Silent.
From Northridge before, like, well, the thing is, like, I was living in an apartment, and I was, like, maybe, like, a little kid, like, tiny little kid, and, like, someone appeared to me, like, before, like, an hour before the earthquake started, and I was in, like, the Northridge epicenter,
mm-hmm.
where everything fell.
Wow.
And it was a green, like, it looked like a skull dude, like, and he kept scaring me to the point that I left. Me and my sister left our, like, room. And then when we left to leave the room, the bed and everything crashed down, and it fell on her bed where she would have died. So I want to know who was that, like, who told me to take my sister out of the room? Who was it? Because it looked like someone. I don't know who it was, though.
What I'm sensing, what I'm getting, it was kind of like a guardian angel thing, but more elemental, more from an elemental, literally like a tree spirit or something like that.
It looked like a skeleton.
Yeah.
Like, it was weird.
They can shapeshift a little bit. But yeah, how he shows, again, that comes by what our knowledge and how we see things, we kind of create some of that. But it really was a warning. And I'm just getting, again, something very elemental, like, from the...
Yeah, because stuff happened in that house. A lot of stuff. A lot of crazy stuff.
Yeah. Did you have a really big tree really close to the house?
Yes.
Yeah. He lived in the tree. It was a tree. It was some kind of a tree spirit.
I need a drink.
I got water. Tree needs water, though. Tree needs water.
He turned the TV on and off a lot until I moved out of the apartment. Yeah. And then he dragged the... From like
what's knocking?
One side of the room to the other. So
okay.
I have no idea who that was.
Yeah. No. I get that was an elemental of some sort, tree spirit, and was there to protect you and a little bit of a mischief maker, because they could be mischief makers too. But they didn't want anybody to die in an earthquake, so. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
We have a question. We did, like, some, it's called the Charlie Challenge.
Mm-hmm.
Have you heard of that?
Oh, I have two pencils.
Okay, so we did that, and we didn't really get any, the whole night. It wasn't a lot of action. I mean, it was actually very action packed, right? Except for the movement of the pencils. I only did it two times. one of the questions asked is, he asked if he's evil.
Mm-hmm.
And then right after that, like within seconds, it was like almost like simultaneous. Am I evil? And it went like super fast. Is there like, I don't know. That's one of the questions we're trying to figure
out. Okay. You can't believe. What? I'm sorry. I was talking over you. You can't believe everything that you hear from a spirit, because more often than not, they're tricksters. Mm-hmm. Just like when people use Ouija boards and stuff, you can't go anybody out there. Charlie is the same. Did you ask for something specific? Did you set up grounding? Who were you talking to? What if it was like the bum outside 7-Eleven? Am I evil? Yeah, you're evil. You know, what if it's just, you know, you have to figure out who you're talking to, if it's somebody who's going to be honest and ethical, in or just honest, if not ethical. Charlie Chaplin, it's challenge is going to bring a lower vibration as a rule. Fun, I mean, it's silly. It's like, but it's the same thing as a Ouija or anything else. It's you've got to direct it and see who's who. I think you. I'm lonely. No, you're not the only. That the machine's lonely. I don't know. The person who said that you were evil, did you know a kid who died in school?
Yes.
Yeah, it's him.
Interesting.
Yeah. Okay. And you're not evil. He just said you're evil because
he's giving you shit.
Giving you shit. That's what a kid would do.
What did you do to the kid? I didn't ever have any bad interactions with him.
No.
At least I don't think so.
And he probably wasn't even being bad by saying you're evil. It's just, how do you decipher, or, you know, it's like misreading a text. Is this a dream? But that's who it was. I just saw this kid, a kid from school, and again, you were here, you're doing the Charlie. You opened a door, like we have the veil now. The door has been open, and we're in smoke. Okay. And we're inviting in, so. I don't think you're evil. I think he thinks it's pretty funny.
Okay.
And when you were, I don't know if you, when you were doing the Charlie Chaplin, I get a lot of physical stuff. Mm-hmm. Something with your thumbs?
No, I mean, my hands were flat on the table. I don't think there was anything going on there.
But, okay, not when you were doing, in life, do you have a thing? Do you feel something with them? Because this kid's going to come play with
you. The only thing I ever do is just, like, crack my thumbs like that.
Ew. Yeah. Okay. Maybe
your
that's
eyes what... glaze over, yeah. Like, when you're seeing something.
Yeah. Or getting talked to.
Yeah. Or getting talked to. That's...
Yeah, you should see when I channel. Well, I don't do that very often anymore, but, like, become somebody else. Okay, maybe it's that thing. Maybe it's a snappy thing. Thumb. I don't know. Did you do that when you were a kid?
Did you break your thumb?
Yeah, I've done it my whole life.
Oh, you broke your thumb.
No, I broke my hand. It was these two fingers.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But maybe this kid was impressed with that.
Completely
possible. Yeah. So again, it's deciphering. But that's who said you were evil, and you're not evil.
Okay.
What about Tim?
Tim, horribly bad, evil, dark.
Ding.
That's why he can't grow a beard, right?
Yeah.
It's pretty rugged.
That's why you use the beard oil.
He puts Rogaine on his face to get that.
Okay.
I do have a question.
Okay.
I've been a mortician for 5 years.
Wow.
Yeah. So I've seen a lot of, you know, death. But my aunt passed away in March. She had leukemia. And I never, like, got a chance to say goodbye. I don't know if it was painful, but I've had a lot of stuff happening at my house.
Okay. You should definitely do a dumb supper for her, a backwards dinner. It's done everywhere except in the United States. It's a dinner for the dead or a silent supper. Have regular dinner, whatever you're having, but you have to do it backwards. Have dessert first, and then you have the main course, then you have your super salad course. You set a place for them if you want, or a glass for them if you want. Talk about whatever you want to talk about, like they are there. Spend a few minutes of the dinner in silence, and she will communicate with whoever's there to your own ability and comfort level. And then at the end of the dinner, which is the beginning of the dinner, yes, we're all right. Because you're up to super salad course, you really have to say goodbye to her physical body. Because I think that's where she's holding on. You have to cut those cords. Because we always have cords. Cut the cords. No strings attached. Living to living, we have these heart-to-heart cords with everybody that's really in our life. When somebody dies, that has to be cut. It has to be a third eye cord. So I think she's still holding on. Or you're still holding on. Or both of you. So do it. You could do it any dinner you're doing. Just do it backwards. Invite her. And then at the end of the dinner, again, you say goodbye to their fleshly body. That's the one thing, as you know, mortician, you can't have back. You know, that you're going to be embalmed or burned or put in the ground. Their spirit lives on and the soul lives on, but you have to let the body go. That's where she's holding on. She wants to get on the train and leave, I guess.
Dude, but that's...
So, yeah.
That train is like, yeah, I want to get the hell out of here.
There's no coincidence that all these cues are happening at the same time.
It's like I think she has a soundboard.
I couldn't even do that.
She brings flowers to her aunt and just said flowers. Yeah, she loves you madly. But do the
backwards dinner.
The backwards dinner, and she'll like it. So and she'll do things around. Again, they will listen to us if we talk nice to them. Always be like mess us, do funny things around. I have a ghost who I love that takes pictures out of frames. And then when you don't want him to do it, just tell him. Tomorrow. January again. We've got two Januaries here. Spanky. Does somebody know somebody named Spanky?
I mean, that's what Ice does all the time.
Looking for someone named Spanky?
Or I'm hearing
Spanky?
Spanky.
I used to have a homie named Spanky.
Yeah?
I'm not familiar.
Are they still alive?
Yeah.
So maybe it's Spanky.
Maybe. Ask him what he did with the chainsaw.
Oh, God.
Do we want to know?
He have the...
Do we want to know what he did with the chainsaw?
I think I hear it outside.
I just had a flashback to some dark times. Like, whoa.
Okay. Are you Spanky?
It's all cold right now. What's up,
buddy? It is really cold. Okay, so who, Spanky, who here do you know?
Uh-oh.
Yeah. What's up?
There you go. He was just kind of yelling at Spanky. So I guess that was for you, Stefan.
Is Spanky the one that wants a drink?
Maybe. Yeah, did you bring him with you from earlier? So Spanky, this is Stefan. Can you make that do something?
Just put your hand over G.
Whew. He just put his hand around his throat like this. Does that mean something to you?
Yeah. He got attacked by the police and they choked him out. Mm. They put a hold on him and they cracked his windpipe and he suffocated.
Mm. Wow.
Fucking A, dude. What was that? Dean?
Was he a teen?
Yeah. Wow, so I guess that's what he just wanted us to know, that's what it was, yeah. Ooh, that's what, he's holding his throat. But he's fine now.
Good.
He's fine.
He's
and something red. What?
Do you,
not now. Okay, I don't know. Does red mean something to you for him? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. That's what he said.
There was another situation around the same time he was with.
Is that the chainsaw?
How's the cat? I heard that again.
It said, how's the cat again? Maybe there's a cat here.
My cat died.
Ah.
What?
The black cat?
Yeah.
The cat that we pet every time we come here, like...
And your cat died?
You're telling us now?
Like a month ago.
Really? Why are you just telling us that?
When it was dead. You were petting it last week.
I could
have died a month
ago.
It was so soft.
On its 10th life.
So is this whoever somebody is talking about because Tim's cat is here?
That's awesome.
Your cat's here, bro.
You got anything to say to that booty cat?
Oh, look at your cat doesn't like you.
What do you
mean?
Are you going to haunt him?
It's...
I mean... I know that he loved me more than anyone in the house.
Yeah.
But at the same time, like, when he was dying, I should have done something else. And I just made the wrong decision.
So I'm sorry.
I mean, I'm not sorry it happened. Like, I'm sorry that he died because of it. And I know he's with me. I feel him all the time.
He's totally with you. He stands somewhere.
You're about to blow my mind. Because go ahead.
Yeah, there's something that looking out, like if there's a thing right here that he could kind of, I don't know if it's a door, a glass door.
Yeah.
That's where he is all the time.
Right out where he's buried?
He's buried out there?
Ah. And he's here. Well, you have other animals, right? Mm-hmm. They'll notice. Okay. Yeah. Let's see. What was his name?
I called him Kitty. His name is Bo.
Kitty.
But it was only Kitty. That's all we called
just
him.
Just Kitty. Okay. Kitties don't talk English. They just talk in words and emotions. I can get meanings off them. Kitty, you could talk into one of these machines. Kitty? Are you in a good place, Kitty? Showing me a little wiggly thing.
Wiggly thing? What do you have with the wiggly thing?
What do you mean?
Toy?
A toy?
Yeah.
He doesn't have no toys. I mean, he never liked any toys. I have something that, but we never use it. I mean, it's like in a, like, is it car or drawer?
I don't know. I don't know.
Okay, it's not in the drawer. It's next to the drawer.
But it's a kitty toy?
Yeah.
Then put it out somewhere.
Oh, that's, he wants it?
Yeah.
He wants to play.
Huh.
Maybe he didn't play in life. Maybe he wants to play now. Maybe you'll see it move around the house
maybe,
or something.
Maybe it's bored.
Wait, he just said dog. Or the girl.
Patricia.
That's me.
Oh.
Duh.
Is there, I mean, I've lost people in life, but uh-huh. My hardest loss is my dog.
Yeah.
Bubba. And I mean, someone opened something, said it. Like, I know he's with me. Did you trip me? Did you trip me? Because I tripped out of nowhere, and I had a high.
Chris.
Just
Chris.
That's him.
Yeah. Okay, so Bubba, did you trip him? Yeah. Not trying to be bad or anything.
I know. It was like 2 days after he died.
Yeah.
It was like the worst day of my life.
So, are you okay, Bubba? And Dave? Okay.
I love you.
Is Dave for you?
What did it say?
Hamburgers. How you feeling, man? Because I know you have other animals and stuff. It's when you least expect it. When you're like sitting on the computer or watching TV.
Hamburgers.
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 I'm sure he didn't eat the hamburgers.
What is he saying? All right, is there something with hamburgers? Because this week we had hamburgers on the counter, and we woke up, they're all gone.
Bubba, did you eat the hamburgers? She's blaming the cat, I think. I don't
know. No, it did say the cat.
Uh-oh. Who else is here?
Somebody coming in? Okay. So, Bubba, did you eat the hamburgers?
No.
No.
Did Finn eat the hamburgers? Fuck yeah, that asshole did.
He would blame it on Finn, though. He would blame Finn.
Does he like the new dog?
Yeah. He does. I think he's going to teach the new dog some stuff.
To trip you.
Yeah.
So high ankle sprain.
No, I, you know, they sometimes do. Like, oh, this is what you do and this is what you don't do. Did it just say ball?
That's what I heard.
The ball?
Game.
Game.
You want to play ball? You want to play a game of ball?
Still thinking like a dog in the afterworld. Squirrel. Yeah.
Yeah.
What happens when they said his name?
I don't know.
Chris. Is there anything for Chris?
Is there... Bubba and Chris, though. Maybe did Bubba have a...
Did you know Bubba? You didn't know him ever?
Bubba who, the dog?
Yeah.
He obviously knew Bubba. We were all here together in the show.
Yeah, dude.
When we were doing Red Light District?
Bubba, that's a black dog.
But he was Oh, yeah.
But did you give him? Did you give him like treats or anything when you were here?
They weren't close. Chris kicked him a couple times.
Hamburger.
Is there someone for him?
Is
why his name got mentioned?
That's when I gave him the hot chili.
Oh no!
That one. You know, hot chili. Let's see. Is there somebody for Chris? You have a lady who watches over you, a little lady. did you have somebody like a grandmother or auntie or something who either had a throat issue or a thyroid or couldn't talk or?
My grandpa.
Your grandpa?
It just said grandma.
Grandma.
You said grandma. Does she have something with her throat?
Or breathing? Or?
I think so. She smoked a lot.
Okay,
that does it.
Okay. So,
is there a will involved?
Was there a will? Okay, so is this Chris's grandma who died?
Nine.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, so do you have something you want to say to him? Yes. Do you want to talk through one of the boxes? This has probably been saying all sorts of stuff.
It just the talkie lit up box. Blue.
Can you tilt it up so we can see what it's spelling?
Yeah, I could do that actually.
Yeah.
Sal. Which way did he?
That's good right there.
Burp. So the person who wants a drink is burping.
Uh-oh.
So the lady who watches out for you, she's like a grandma. And something about shoes.
Take them off before you get in the house.
Yeah, he's Asian.
Yeah,
that's the rule.
Well, keep saying no. Why is it saying no?
We haven't asked it anything.
Oh.
Ask it something.
Ask it something.
This is your chance. Anything.
C. D. D. I.
Correct.
Disc. D-I-S-C. Discover. Yeah, it says discover.
Discover.
You been watching a lot of Discovery Channel?
I watch it all the time.
Do you?
It keeps discover. It keeps spelling out discover. I see. Oh.
Journey.
Discover.
Discover. So.
That's a weird word,
huh?
We definitely are discovering these people right now.
Are we discovering these people? Yes. Okay. Hamburger.
Yeah.
Is there someone standing like mm-hmm. right here?
Yeah, that's his brother.
I like really feel it.
Okay. So, Paul, right? Where are you?
Okay.
He's right there.
He's in the stool.
Diva.
Okay.
That's Paul.
That's Paul. That's
Paul. He called you a diva because you asked again?
We're related.
He's a diva.
I love that guy.
Do you like get anything from my direction considering?
Oh, considering your work as a mortician?
Yeah.
You mean?
Oh, no.
Hey, I cheers.
It's your month?
September.
Okay. You have...
Four.
You have an energy around you. It's almost like a protective energy. Almost like this. whatever it comes from, I don't know. But I think you're not going to get bothered by spirits in a negative way at all. It's like a protection thing, energy. I think they get you. They respect you. They get what you do. You work for them in a weird way.
Oh, oh shit!
That's definitive.
But I've been very sensitive when I was a little child. Oh. I've seen apparitions. Mm-hmm. And there was a couple shadows. I mean, when I turned my head, because I slept on a bunk bed, when I turned my head, I couldn't see anybody there, but when I looked at the wall, there was a silhouette mm-hmm. of a woman sitting there, and then a few nights later, it was a silhouette of a man. And I'd never, ever met these people before, and then right after my grandma passed away, I saw her silhouette, and I knew exactly mm-hmm. who she was. So I've been, like, sensitive to it pretty much my entire life. But yeah. I mean, even at the mortuaries, I would see things at the corner of my eye, or I'd see somebody walking away.
So you're really sensitive. You're high sensorial. You're very gifted. Just don't overthink it. But spirits, again, they know it's you. They know it's that you're good. You help the living. You help the dead. Like I said, most dead people are fine.
Can you see a person's aura?
Yeah.
What's wrong, lighting, Patty?
Something's pushing into my head.
What?
Is someone...
That's my grandmother.
Really? That's your grandmother?
She's living still, but that's my grandmother.
Okay. So somebody's just saying hey to her, her. I don't know. I just got this big, like, somebody going, like, didn't feel...
It just spelled out Betty.
It just spelled out Betty? Yeah. Well, we had a Betty, right? We had a Betty.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had a Betty. So who is this? Who is going to punch my head in?
It's doing it again.
What's wrong with you, him?
This is... What this is being doing, this is some... This is for one of you. I think it's on this side of the room. Not sure.
Lonely.
We know. You're lonely. It's a lonely box. Do one of... Could be the site. Do you remember somebody? I think it was you were pretty little, and somebody would do this to you, like maybe like a grandpa or something. You know, people do to kids. That's what it looks like, a grandpa kind of person. But it doesn't look like they're trying to be bad. It's just.
Cover your ears?
Yeah, just kind of like bump, bump, bump. You know, you walk by, bump, bump, bump to a kid. Are you sure it's not deflecting to you, Tim? I think it is.
I mean, there's a lot of different things that... All right, there's a lot of different things in my life that I block out. And I don't think about them. And since I haven't thought about it, okay. I forgot about it.
Okay.
And both of them include both of my grandfathers.
Okay. Okay, so I would say that this is one of your grandfathers here doing
There's
this.
one grandfather that, for me, was evil.
Okay.
Or bad.
Okay.
The other one was just misunderstood.
Okay.
So.
Is it?
Did that just say bad?
Bad.
Okay. Is this good grandpa?
Or Ed or Tony?
Is this Ed? Is this Tony? Tony.
Good.
Is that the good grandpa? Okay. Yeah, because it didn't feel bad to me. It was like it was playing.
Inside the car. I'm getting a flashback.
Okay, yeah.
There's a red car? There's a red car? Is there a red car?
Is there a red car?
Like a Cadillac?
That was
a
red car.
Tony. Or Chrysler?
Tony's red car.
No, red interior?
What was red?
A lot of cars in the
he would,
had red interior.
I think the car was like maroon.
Okay.
Oh.
He used to cover my ears when he was talking to my grandma.
Yeah, that's it. That's what he's doing. Yeah.
And
I
then,
get goosebumps.
And then any time I would walk by him, he would pretend like, oh, and then grab. I fucking forgot all about this.
Wow.
That's sort of strange. You don't remember he used to do that? Nope. That's your dad.
I saw angels.
What is he doing around me? I didn't know that we were close. I mean, I don't remember. I was six.
I think he just likes you. He appreciates who you are. He appreciates who you become.
Oh, no way.
At least someone does.
It's spelled out Christmas. It's spelled out Christmas? Did you have something with him at Christmas?
Yeah.
Remember? Yeah.
Yeah.
What happened at Christmas, Tim?
Tiny Tim.
I love you.
Okay, you want to know what happened at Christmas?
Yeah.
Oh, no. All
right, so at Christmas.
Cue the piano music.
Yeah.
He bought me a G.I. Joe set. I peeked in and I opened the gift and I taped it back up. And then I went to him and I said, I don't like G.I. Joe's for Christmas. That's what happened.
You jerk.
I was like maybe five, dude.
Who doesn't like G.I. Joe's?
Right? I would like Pearl's wrestling.
Best toy ever.
Well.
I liked wrestling.
I like G.I. Joe's and I like wrestling.
I didn't want that. I wanted wrestling.
Barbie likes G.I. Joe. Better than Cam. Mm.
That's amazing. I never knew that there's... Like, I didn't think I had a connection with the afterlife at all.
Everybody does. You could not
I just don't
pay
feel
attention.
It.
Or you... It's still... But you could. And right now, we are just not even...
Papa?
Did
you call him Papa?
Papa.
You would say Papa.
That's why I got it for you. That's why I told Julian to call you Papa. Because I called Grandpa Papa.
Yeah, wow. I just said it. Isn't that...
It's like a big family reunion.
It's a big family reunion.
Oh, my God. Thank you. I need to give her a hug when she leaves. That's amazing.
How come he's told me I love you yes. a third less...
From the beyond.
Just right now, he's told me I love you one third more than you've done in your whole life.
He's in a different dimension.
In this entire score, this past 20 years.
Do you want to talk to him?
No, I've got nothing to say.
No?
You don't want to talk to your dad?
Fuck him, huh, Grandpa?
He's boring. I don't know what to ask.
Beat him up.
Hey, Dad, how you doing?
Miss you, Dad.
Yeah.
My father knew five different languages.
Talk into the microphone, please.
Like you've done this before?
No. My question is, why did you ever teach me any of those languages that you already knew?
Because you're dumb.
Or how to play a musical instrument, which you knew how to play four of them.
See, I told you, Dad. Genius skips a generation. Grandpa, okay. You, me.
Maybe two generations.
Julian's fucked.
He just said that. I don't know what it said. I don't think he thought you wanted to.
You just want to smoke pot.
I talked to him.
He's
the one that told me I should play the guitar. And every time I try to play, I can't.
Why?
It don't work. I just can't do it. My guitar don't work.
My fingers don't do it with my brain. I told my brain to tell my fingers to do something. It's not doing it.
Patty, like this whole thing has been amazing. I've loved every second.
Just like
it's
not
going to
do the Ouija board.
Is it?
Oh yeah, shoot. Where can people? Let's wrap it up. Where can people find you? And I will also. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put together a 8.5 by 11 ad for your book, and I'm gonna put it in our magazine for you coming in.
Oh.
We have a monthly publication, and it. It's obviously 19.1 million people subscribe.
once you leave, it'll go back to two.
That's awesome. Thank you. I'm honored. I will spread the word. So, find me at pattynegri.com. This is my book, Old World Magic for the Modern World. You can get it on Amazon, $6 to $12, ebook, audiobook, print book. There's magic in it. There's Dumb Supper in it, how to talk. I'm going to leave this one here with you, and you have to share it with everybody.
Awesome.
Negri, N-E-G-R-I, N-E-G-R-I.
Just don't pronounce it.
If when I finish reading it, can we set up another time for you to come back?
I would love it.
Okay, I'm going to read it from front to back.
Okay, please do.
And when I'm done, I will
we
contact
can talk
you via
magic.
Stefan.
Maybe you guys could do something together.
It just said bye. PattyNegri.com, PattyNegri.com. Yeah, so Thank you for that. That is awesome. So I will leave this here. But we have to close this.
Okay.
We can't leave this open. Okay. So everybody, again.
Sean, sit down.
Everybody take a deep breath. Take a deep breath again. And if you're comfortable with it, close your eyes for just a second. I like to do this. And call your loved ones in, whether we talk to them directly or not. Because there's, like I said, there is an entourage of, that we didn't all talk to. Have them, if you're comfortable with it, have them come right up to you. If they have a message for you, ask them. Maybe they'll whisper it to you on your inside voice or your outside voice. It doesn't matter. If you're comfortable with it, maybe they'll ask them to touch your arm, touch your head, touch your cheek. But again, what they're getting out of this is real-time communication, and it makes them very happy. We get the information we get titillation, but they get to be a little bit alive in this realm. So thank them and see them stepping back into the darkness. See them stepping back into the darkness. Know they will always be there for you as we slowly close the veil between the worlds. Okay. Okay, now everybody should get mundane, even you people in the listening world. Eat salt, touch iron, and tell bad jokes.
Well, that's what we do here in all.
Yeah.
We tell a bunch of bad jokes here. Did you hear when you were closing it, it said happy love?
Oh, good.
Happy love?
Happy love. Love, happy. That's love, it said happy. Love, happy in those orders.
That's good.
Are you playing Japanese anime?
All right, well, happy we are, love. All right. Patty, go to pattynegri.com. It is... Oh my God! There's so many awesome things that we experienced today, and thank you so much.
I got so much closure today.
Thank you, awesome. And thank you. Awesome. He's with you at corner. The little.
You guys will stop doing that when you go to sleep.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. We will be right back with plastic culture. Man,
I need some weed.
You need to take a shower. Yeah.
I need some weed. Right
we'll be
now.
Right back I after this.
Make it a microphone check. Give it a microphone, I make the make it a microphone dead. Don't step to me, newbie, I could truly be moody. I could've played the fucking Grinch in the movies. I've been a part-time shadow cat, part-time. That is not a guy that I would ever wanna try to battle rap. Snap, crack a pot, mind fried to a crisp. Make an MC into a wide-eyed lunatic. We'll be right back.
so they can't. I pull this burner out of my pain. Chop, chop him up where he stands. They claim to be who they ain't. Try to knock my hustle, they can't. I pull this burner out of my pain. They claim to be who they ain't.
Try to battle rap. Snap, crack a pop, mind fried to a crisp. Make an MC into a wide-eyed lunatic.
Thank you.
you. El profesor is in the house, let me teach you. I could defeat you with two hands tied and have you waking in the hospital like, who am I? And who are you? Who are they? What is this? You wouldn't believe how someone react to this shit. The mind slips, slips, slipping, speaking in tongues. Sly Ink, GVA, that's how we get it done. 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 Sly Ink, GVA, that's how we get it done.
Try to battle rap. Snap, crackle, pop, mind fried to a crisp. Make an MC into a wide-eyed lunatic.
a minute, I'ma eat you. El profesor is in the house, let me teach you. I could defeat you with two hands tied and have you waking in the hospital like, who am I? And who are you? Who are they? What is this? You wouldn't believe how someone react to this shit. The mind slips, slips, slipping, speaking in tongues. Fly Inc. GVA, that's how we get it done. 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 Sly Inc. GVA, that's how we get it done.
Try to battle rap. Snap, crackle, pop, mind fried to a crisp. Make an MC into a wide-eyed lunatic.
teach you. El profesor is in the house, let me teach you. I could defeat you with two hands tied and have you waking in the hospital like, who am I? And who are you? Who are they? What is this? You wouldn't believe how someone react to this shit. The mind slips, slips, slipping, speaking in tongues. Sly Inc. GVA, that's how we get it done. 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 Sly Inc. GVA, that's how we get it done.
Where he stand.